But one day I took a drink from a well, and every need that I have, all my desires have been fulfilled in Christ. I want to tell you about salvation. I want to explain it to you, but I can't really do it justice. So all I can say is, oh, taste and see. Make sure that this gospel doesn't go over anybody's head, that everybody that comes to an altar and gets saved, that they fully develop, they fully mature. The only way, saints, that that's going to happen, my God, is for them to have all five of the spiritual senses. If they miss one of them, they're going to be in trouble. We may not see them again. We may not know where they're at. They may be around here, but they'll never ever become Zion. They may be around Zion, but they'll never become Zion if they don't go on to possess and develop and mature all five of the spiritual senses.
This poor man cried.
And the Lord heard him.
And saved him out of all his troubles. The angel of the Lord encamped around about them.
Yes.
That fear him.
Yes.
And delivered them.
Thank you, Lord.
Oh, taste and see. That the Lord is good.
Come on, now he's saying, I'm telling you about it. This poor man cried, but listen, I'm just letting you know, when it comes to salvation, when it comes to what he did for my soul, he pulled me up out of a horrible pit. Amen, set my feet up on a rock. Amen, put a new song in my heart. I don't sing the blues anymore. I sing, my God, be an overcomer. Only cowards yield. Thank God I have joy. I may not have money, but I got joy. I got peace, my God. When I was out there in sin, I was searching, trying to find it. But one day I took a drink from a well, and every need that I have, all my desires have been fulfilled in Christ. I want to tell you about salvation. I want to explain it to you, but I can't really do it justice. So all I can say is, oh, taste and see that the Lord, I can't tell you how good he is. You can't comprehend how good God is. He forgave me for all my sins. Amen. He delivered me. He set my feet on a rock. He gave me joy. He gave me peace. He gave me grace. He gave me purpose. Oh, he loves me. When mother and father forsake me, then the Lord hugs me. When I'm all alone and I can't see my way through, there's always a light at the end of the tunnel. Oh, it's good. Oh, it's wonderful. Oh, I recommend him.
Thank you. See, my God.
There's nobody that can preach salvation to the point it needs to be preached. There's nobody that can tell you about it in their testimony to the extent that they need to really tell you. So here David said, I'm cutting it all out. You just gotta taste it.
My God. Amen.
The word taste there means you must experience it. You gotta experience how good it is. You can't fathom. I used to hear old Brother Pitt say, salvation is a wonderful thing. It's a wonderful thing to be saved. I heard him say it, but it wasn't until I got a taste myself, Brother Anthony.
My God.
That I understood. I had to experience it myself. One person was saying it's like buttery kind of ice cream, because somebody ain't never heard of it, never seen it. And they sitting there, what does it taste? It's good, it's cream, it's salty, but it's sweet. Here, man, you gotta try. Just try it.
My God, you gotta.
And that's how it is with salvation, man. We can try to sing, and they do a good job with it. We can testify and run around a building, but that still don't do it justice. You gotta taste this thing. So the ability to taste is the ability to develop an experience with God on a personal level. It's important that sense is developed, and that sense is developed not in the lab, not in studying a book, but that sense is developed by going through.
My God.
Ability to taste is symbolic of that experience you have. He said over in Romans, he said, tribulations worketh patience, and patience, experience, and experience, hope or assurance. Because when you get a real experience, God witnesses to it. You ain't going nowhere. Winds may come, winds may blow. You ain't going nowhere. You got an experience now, not theory. Some people, they are fantastic in an empty gym with a punching bag. Oh, they look so good. Oh, they look so good. Woo! Woo! Right. Oh, but when they get into that ring, now they got some experience. Then they come through a few fights and they felt like their lungs was on fire. And it was still 2 minutes left in the round. Or you got hit right there with an uppercut. Your knees are just wobbling. So now you gotta go in and grab them and just hold on to them. My God, hold on. Then the ref separates you. Amen. You gotta take a few moments to get a hold on. Just jab. Just keep them at bay. Okay, 30 seconds left. Okay, now go back. It's some experience. This sense here, Ote, you gotta develop an experience with God. Hold on, Lord. I'm getting before you. I want to develop an experience. And how do you develop that experience? By going through right. I don't want to cut no corners. Lord, I'm hurting right now. I'm hurting and I want to say something. But I got to learn to lean on you. I got to learn to let you fight my battles. I got to learn to hurt. See, some people got to learn to hurt. You got to learn. I got to learn to be able to hurt but still function. I got to be able to learn to hurt but still fight. I got to be able to learn to hurt and still press the battle on. I don't feel the best, but my God, I'm still going to, my God, have my devotion. I don't feel the best, but I'm still going to press my way out to the house of God. I don't, you done got you some experience. Oh, look at you. Oh, they talked about me. I'm staying home. Girl, you better get you some experience. They ain't got no heaven to put you in, and they ain't got no church to put you out of. This ain't their church. You don't come to church to please them. You come to church to hear from the word, a word from the Lord. Yo, listen, I ain't gonna testify. They not gonna receive. Listen, my God, if God give you something, don't look at their faces, my God. You better get you some experience. Everybody not gonna pat you on the back all the time. You not always gonna feel like a bed of roses. You not all, the song poet said, must we be carried to the skies on flowery beds of ease while others fought to win the prize and sail through bloody seas. Sure, I must fight. If I would reign, increase my courage, Lord.
My God. Amen.
You got to develop some experience. This is a battle. We in war. We need to know that if I look over my shoulder, you're going to be there. I can't have you, my God. I'm hurt by this and hurt. No, lick your wounds and get up and fight.
My Lord. My God.
You got to develop some experience. Hold on. I'm going again. So I'm going to let a depression spirit come up over me. People think that, oh, if I can just get married, then I'm over all my battles. Please. As Brother Hampton said, my God, there's battles of every phase, of every situation. It continues on. Here you are fighting the enemy because he's saying that you're never going to get chosen. You're never going to get married. You're never going to do this, that, and the other. And that's a real battle. But you got to, hold on, devil. Hold on, devil. Okay, listen. I might, amen, have a desire, and I do have a desire to be married, but I want the devil to know I'm not going nowhere. I'm not going to cut no corners, and I'm not going nowhere, period. I'm not, no. Devil, I'm not going to even allow you to depress me. I'm not going to allow you to force me and get my head down. God, you've been so good to me. Lord, I love you. Lord, yes, I have that desire, but I'm going to hold that desire in check and not allow the devil to buffet me every time he comes with a thought of it. I can't hardly sleep. No, I'm going to develop my experience to the point that I can go through some things, my God, and come out on the other side. Okay, I'm going again. Baby's not 1 year old, so jump out the window of the car. Just leave. Oh no. Lord, if I am, you got to give me grace.
Grace, Lord.
You got to give me grace, Lord. If I am,
amen,
I'm going to start reading the scriptures. If I have another one, then God going to give me the wherewithal. God going to help me out. God going to give me strength. Sometimes when they're closer together, they play better together, and you ain't got to take care of them as much. See, it's always some bright side of something. And you got to learn an experience to develop and look at that. You know, some people, that's how you make it through. When you look at a situation that's dark, learn the ability to find a bright piece of it and focus on that. You got to find, Lord, I ain't got a job right now. You know what? I can make every service. I mean, you find something. This is spiritual warfare. You got to learn how to battle, my God. Oh, hold on, like I was preaching the other night. Well, I got a headache. Well, it could be worse.
It could be worse.
I mean, you just look at you. You got some experience. The devil's sad. He throws stuff at your way and get those that don't have experience. They down, cast down, upset, mad. But here you with some experience. Oh, no. Why? Because they understand the joy of the Lord is our
strength.
Thank the Lord. Thank the Lord. Thank the Lord.